When test data and match data agree perfectly, we see a green block with a yellow check near the test data summary box, as shown here. However, any differences found in either the connectors or the wiring will cause an error to be flagged. The model M3 CableEye will also detect resistance threshold violations and resistance tolerance errors, while our model HVX high voltage tester will in addition check for dielectric breakdown and insulation resistance. CableEye alerts you to an error in four different ways. First, the green block that denotes a good cable changes to a red block with a black X for a bad cable. In this case, we can easily see from the wiring schematic that an open circuit exists in the DB9 male-to-female cable. Pass and fail indicators on the tester itself also show the test result, so in production testing, you don't need to look at the screen. Because a wire is missing in this cable, the fail indicator comes on. If you've set up the system to use automatic testing, something we'll discuss in a later clip, you may sound a tone of your choice on the audio speakers, amplify to whatever level is needed in your lab or production area. Finally, you may show only the wiring differences during testing. Just click on the Delta button, which looks like a triangle. The differences screen graphically shows only the errors, while hiding the correct wiring. If you wish, you can show the errors overlaid on the correct wiring by pressing the Delta Plus button. Looking at the differences in the form of a netlist can be helpful for more detail. Viewing netlist differences identifies errors quickly when the wiring is complex or when you test wire harnesses with many connectors. Here, you see a minus sign to indicate a missing connection. Extra connections, which are shorts, would be shown with a plus sign and a red highlight. During testing, you may wish to keep the differences list window visible at all times. I'll replace the missing wire and retest the cable to show how the differences list changes when there are no errors. Now, back to the error. The netlist may be printed if desired by clicking the print button. This shows the differences report you would get for this cable. I'll correct the error again and retest the cable. When using the CableEye M3 or HVX testers, resistance errors will also be flagged. Resistance thresholds appear at the bottom of the screen. In this case, we have the maximum permissible resistance of a wire set to 10 ohms, and the minimum isolation for unconnected wires set to 1 megohm. To demonstrate what happens when the low threshold is violated, I'll insert a resistor higher than 10 ohms in one of the wires and retest the cable. You may hover over the resistor symbol on the schematic to see its value. You may also look at the differences screen to see a dotted line showing a partial connection. Or look at the netlist differences. I'll now remove the resistance and retest the cable.